Hello, and welcome to episode 19 of my Rising World tutorial Let's Play series. This episode will be on taking a look at the grill, smoker, and also the cooking grill. So we're going to make them and then see how they are used. Now, to make them, we are going to go to the workbench and we're going to go to crafting stations, I think it is. No, I suspect I'm wrong, so it's okay, we're just going to find them. Is it under utilities? No. Oh, for goodness sake, where on earth? Oh, here they are. Right, so they're under miscellaneous in the workbench. Well, I've got the right crafting station before y'all start shouting at me. At least I've got the right station. You know my level of incompetence. It's lucky I didn't go to the forge to make these items. Anyway, so under miscellaneous is where we will find the grill, smoker, and cooking grill. So let's start with the grill then. What will that do for us? A grill can be used to barbecue meat. Yep, looks just like the Sunday Barbie dinner. So we're going to need 6 iron plates and 8 iron rods. So let's go into the inventory. Now, to make all of that, I'm going to need some ingots. So let's go to what I've made previously and grab them up. No, I didn't say jump, I said grab them. It'll help if I'm pushing the right key, of course. There we go, got there in the end. It's the trouble, I'm facing the screen with my keyboard behind me, so you just have to bear with me. What can I say? Okay, let's grab a load more, because I suspect we're going to need them. I want to thank you all for your comments. Some really lovely helpful comments, and I want to apologize about my house, my mud house. I didn't stop for a moment to think about how, whilst I can see it just about what I'm doing, of course those of you viewing would have much more difficulty in seeing what I'm doing, so I'm sorry about that. I should have just made it all out of stone. But of course your comments once again have helped me by making me realize the foolishness of my ways, so in future I will stick to just building in brick or a material where it's much easier to see what I'm doing, so you can see what I'm doing. So my apologies about that. No more brick houses, no more mud houses, promise. So anyway, let's go back here with all these ingots and start making what we need. Wow, I'm nearly at 20 episodes, so I might have to go one or two past 20 in order to show you all what I wanted to. I just want to show you all the current content in the game. Right, so to make these plates, what do we need? 6 iron plates, 8 iron rods. We're going to use the anvil and resources. So we need 6 iron plates and 8 iron rods. Probably got it back to front. Oh, I haven't got enough iron. Oh, I hope I've smelted enough. Oh no, don't do this to me. Wait a minute. Don't panic. Oh, look at that. That was lucky. I've got 53 ingots. Wait a minute. I must have read that wrong. Let's try this again. I bet I needed to make something in order to do them. Requires 1 iron plate. Ah, so the plates, I need to make a load more. Oh, for goodness sake, this is getting complicated. So I'm going to need 12 iron plates and 8 iron... No. So let's make 2 more iron plates. Now I can make 8 iron rods. Now I need to make 6 more iron plates. Right, we got there in the end. Let's now make ourselves a grill. Okay, now let's look at how we use the grill. So we're going to put it on the hot bar and we will stick it in this line of our cooking equipment. So if I place it to the right. Oh, I'm going to need... That's a good excuse for me to terraform all that land down. We're going to need more room. So let's place it there. Now, question. Does it need fuel? Well, let's find out. So, if I press the F key on it, turn on or off. Let's turn it on. How do I turn it on? Is it on or is it off? I don't know if it's on. Let's go in my pocket. What can we put on this? Does it fit a raw rib? Yes, it does. Oh, it fits more than one. So... There we go. So let's see. What else can we put on there? Can we put a steak on there? Yeah. And lastly, can we put some bacon on there? We just need some eggs, and then we're sorted. So we can fit a rasher of bacon. Yeah, there we go. Some rashers of bacon. Can we fit any more? No. So perhaps I could get a steak here, but just to demonstrate, we'll have one of each. And we'll leave that cooking. Well, I'm guessing it's cooking. I don't know. It doesn't really tell me much. I don't know whether it's on or off. Doesn't look on, does it? Doesn't look like there's anything happening. But if you do the F key on it, it brings that option off up in front of us. Turn on or off. But it don't seem to be turning it. It's like I'm not clicking the right key. No, I'm just going through every key here to try and work out how to turn the blinking thing on. Let's take that off of the bacon, otherwise I'm going to end up eating raw bacon. Right, okay, let's leave that for now. It might be on for all I know, although it's highly unlikely it's on, as I haven't done anything to it. But then I can't work out how to do that at the moment. Let's hit it with the rake. Yeah, there you go. Right, let's make the next item. So that's the grill. Next, the smoker. Where's my workbench gone? Okay, so the smoker, we are going to need... Oh my goodness, here we go. It's going to get nasty on me now. I'm going to need to smelt more iron because... I'm not sure if I'm going to have enough to do this. Have I got any more iron ore? Please let me have more iron ore. Dirt. I've got one iron. Oh, look at that. Now that, just call me lucky. What's this? Is that copper? So I've got 61 more iron. I better get smelting. Let's use the big furnace. And hopefully I can demonstrate what I was talking about with how much fuel you need for this. So let's bring up my inventory. Put the iron lumps in here. I've got enough iron to do these two items that I need to do. If not, I'm going to be in trouble. No doubt they'll start yelling at me. Came to do you incompetent fool. Yeah, this is nice and big. I really am going to need to go and mine a load more iron. Full up. How much more have I got left? 5. That should be enough. I'm going to put these back away. Now, what I want to demonstrate is exactly how much fuel you need to put in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to grab some coal. And also I'm going to have some lumber. So let's demonstrate. So with this big furnace, I said it requires 50 fuel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one coal in, which will give me 40 fuel, I believe. I won't know, now I've got 48 in a minute, 38 fuel in there at the moment. So what I can do is just stick two lumber in there. Now, I don't know if 48 is going to be enough. I know 50 is, but I'm not sure about 48. So let's just do a little test, shall we? Let's turn it on. So it's got 48 fuel in it. Let's see if that's enough to smelt all of this iron. Whilst that is smelting, let's check the food. It's probably all black and carbonized by now, just like my cooking in real life. Ah, the bacon looks good. Yeah, oh yeah, you can see that just cooked. Perfectly timed. So let's grab that. Let's grab, oh, it says, yep, that's cooked. What about the ribs? Do they look cooked to you? I don't want to burn them. Oh, so the so this thingy is on after all. I didn't even know if it was on or off, but it's definitely on because my meat has cooked. And them ribs, I don't know whether they're cooked or not. I'm going to leave them a bit longer. We'll see if they burn, shall we? Anyway, let's make the next item in the list on the agenda, which of course is the smoker. So I need 12 iron plates. Okay, iron plates. Let's put that to 12. Okay, let's now make ourselves a smoker. A smoker can be used to barbecue meat. Nice. Let's now go place this at the end. My ribs done. They look done to me. Yeah, I'm going to take them because they look done. No, they're not done. Alright, let's put them back. I shouldn't imagine they'll take much longer. Right, let's put the next cooking apparatus down, which is the smoker. I'm a smoker too, actually. Oh, this is a bit bigger. Let's space it out. Now, this looks like it's one of the items you can need to turn around to, depending on what direction you want to stand to use it. Because I'm standing this side, it makes sense to turn it around. Do you see, can you see that? Let's put the light on. Let's shed some light on the subject. So you see, that looks like it's the front of it. So let's place it down there. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like I placed it backwards. Oh, no. That does look like the front. Open. Yeah. Right, okay. So this is going to barbecue some meat. No, I didn't say I wanted to... Oh, for goodness sake, let's open it back up. Let's go into my pocket. Okay, let's first see if we can smoke some bacon. Yes, we can. And you see the surface is a great big... none of these apparatus need any fuel. Isn't that cool? So let's put a load of bacon down, shall we? So it looks like we can fit two bacon... Or can I fit more than two? Yeah, I can fit more than two. Look at that. Can I fit one over there? No. What about on the edge? So you can get three in a row. Oh no, well perhaps four. Yeah, look, there it goes. Where are you? So you can get four in a row. Let's put down the rest. You really get a load of bacon from the pigs. Definitely worth hunting the pigs. Right, I actually want to demonstrate, see what else we can cook on there. Let's try a rack of ribs. Yep, you can. So you can do ribs too. Can we turn the ribs around? Yes, we can. So, oops, there's the timer. Oh, I'm nowhere near done yet, so I'm afraid this episode's going to go over. That's the 15 minutes for those of you that feel faint after watching me for 15 minutes. And also for those of you that are using my episodes to help you sleep. But that's the 15 minute timer. Anyway, if you use the numbers 4 and 6 on the numpad, you can turn the meat around. Isn't that cool? Look at that, I can fit that right over that bacon. Talk about maximising the space. Now, I might have a ribs done yet, for goodness sake. No, they still look raw. But I'm not sure I could tell the difference. Anyway, that looks... yeah, it looks the same as that. Okay, so let's see if we can now put some steaks on there. I like my steak. Yeah, we can get a few steaks. Remember, you can use the numlock number 4 and number 6 to rotate your steaks. And as you can imagine, I could fit a load. Let's put two on there. There we go. Two steaks. Now, I imagine this contraption, this smoker, is on by default, just like the other one. So I'm just going to wait and see. Right, that brings us to the last one on the list, which is the cooking grill. How does it differ between the grill and the smoker? Well, let's go take a look. Now, I hope these ribs don't burn. Right, they take ages. Okay, so let's go back to the workbench and see what we need to make the last one on the list, which is the cooking grill. So, oh, that's not bad. Can be used to cook meat, can only be placed on top of a campfire. Now, for those of you of keen mind, have you noticed how this says can only be placed on top of a campfire? And yet, if you want to make... if you want to make the item, it's actually called a fireplace. Did any of you notice that? See, fireplace. And yet, this calls it a campfire. Anyway, let's stop waffling and just create it, shall I? You're probably all shouting at me by now. Get on with it. Right, okay, so that we know we need a campfire. I've made a campfire. Now we need just one iron plate. Let's do it. Because the timer has gone. Now let's make ourselves a cooking grill. Yay. There we go. Right, let's go place this campfire. Where shall I place it? You can't pick up either of the skewers or this, whatever it's called. Let's just put the campfire. Let's flatten out a bit of ground here and make room for a campfire. Any excuse to terraform. And I'm going to probably have to go right back to the beach now. Although, no, I'm not, because this is all the cooking stuff done with this episode. In the next episode, we're going to take a look at cloth. Making cloth. I'm also going to show you what the use for leather is. Sorry about the long delay from when I made leather. It was just thing after thing of that I wanted to show you. Someone mentioned they wanted me to build a house, so I built a house. Alright, a mud house, a mud hut in the wilderness. Right, let's put down the campfire here at the end. And then we've got a nice tidy line of cooking structures. Okay, so we'll put it, apparatus I should say. So we'll put it, no, I'm doing this wrong. I need to put the campfire down first. Let's put it there. Plus it lights up my settlement nicely. Okay, let's now put the grill on the top, like so. And now we can, let's check these ribs. They must be cooked by now. You'd have thought out the three of these, the one that takes the time is the smoker, because it's like got to smoke them up. With this one, it's like, I presume these are hot coals in there. You'd think it would cook it. The other two meats were really fast. But that still does not look cooked. looks exactly the same as that one. Anyway, let's put some, see what we can put on this. So if we go into the pocket, let's first try some ribs. Can we get ribs? Yeah, we can. So this is much better than the other campfire items, because you can fit more on this. So there's some ribs. Let's put some bacon down. Let's face it, you can't have enough bacon. Just need loads of eggs. And let's put down some... what's this? Oh, that's a cooked bacon. Let's put down some steak. Wow, look, you can nearly pile up on top of each other. But I won't be able to see if it's cooked or not, so I'll put it there. Now, with the steaks, of course, well, with all the meat, we don't want to lose any of it by burning it, so we need to keep our eyes on it. Oh, is that all my steak gone? Yeah. Okay, a little bit of room for some bacon. So you can see, you can get quite a bit of meat on that. Let's fill the rest of these up now that we've got them all placed. I'll probably find out in another hour's time that none of this is non. I don't know, it's a smoker. How long does a smoker take? I know I take about 5 minutes when I smoke, but I'm not sure about this thing. Okay, that's about as much as I can get on that. Are these ribs done yet? Yep, they're now cooked. You see that? That definitely looks cooked. So there we go, one cooked ribs. Let's put the rest of this bacon down. Oops, didn't mean to pick it up, meant to put it down. Pushing the wrong keys again. Yeah, I'm not sure I like this one because there isn't that much room on it. I much prefer the cooking grill. Oh, is that all my meat gone? Oh no, I've got some... oh, wait a minute, look, I've got a chicken. I didn't even see that. Let's put the chicken on there. Can we put the... yeah, look at that. Can't beat chicken. Chicken and beef, they're my favourite too. Okay, right, that's enough cooking, I think. So there you can see, between the last episode and this episode, there are 5 different items you can... I'm going to call them items. There's 5 different items you can use to cook your meats, as you can see across the board. The smoker's really... which one was it? Was it this one? One of them was really quick at cooking. I think it was this one, wasn't it? No. Oh, I don't know. I've lost the plot. I've lost the will to live at this point. So there we go, though. That's a fine demonstration of how they're made and how to use them. In the next episode, we will look at the loom and the spinning wheel. I think that's what they're called. And we'll have some fun turning cotton into cloth. And as you can see, I'm prepared. I've got lots of cotton plants all done. So there we have it. That's the cooking done with the grill, smoker and cooking grill. Wherever you are in the world, God bless you and keep every last one of you safe. Thank you for watching and have a fantastic day. Goodbye.